Hello friends, welcome to Unity Lighting Essentials video tutorials series. In the previous video tutorials, we discussed what is light, light terminologies, we discussed various kinds of lights, we discussed directional light, spotlight, point light, ambient light. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss area light. Area light emits light in a specified direction in a rectangular shape. Area light comes in a rectangular shape, guys. It affects the scene only when we generate light maps. That is, we bake the light. Light whose lighting effect is computed and updated on each frame at runtime is called as real-time light. Real-time light is used for illuminating movable objects or dynamic objects. For example, objects which we move, for example, player, vehicles, etc. We illuminate them with the help of real-time lights because we need to calculate the shadows in real-time, right? Bake light is a light whose lighting effect is pre-computed before the runtime. Bake light is used for illuminating immovable objects, that is, objects which we never move, for example, ground, walls, building, trees, hills, etc., etc., etc. Effects of light is pre-computed for immovable objects and written on textures. Then the resultant textures are overlaid on immovable objects. The resultant textures are called as light maps. There are situations where you need not to calculate the effect of light on each frame at runtime. You can pre-compute them before itself. For example, the effect of light on the ground, effect of light on the walls of the house. You can pre-compute them before itself. To do that, we take help of bake lights, guys. Let's understand how do we create the area light and use it, and how do we generate light maps, etc., etc., etc. I go to Unity. I'm going to create one cube here. I say GameObject 3D Object Cube. You can see that the cube is created. I scale it in X axis by 10. I scale it in Z axis by 10. I select the cube and press F2 key and rename it to ground. I minimize the Unity, minimize the world. Here I have the ground texture. I'm going to drag it to the assets folder. You can see that the ground texture is imported. I drag it on to the ground game object. You can see that the ground texture is applied. Now what do? We are going to create the area lights. I say game object light and area light. You can see that the area light is created. It is baked only light. So I just set here width to 4.5 and I set the height of the area light to 8.5. And I move it up by 4 units. I move it left by minus 2.5 units. So you can see that we have the area light. And I select this one and press F2 key, rename it to red area light. I change the color of this to red color. And then I select the red area light, press Ctrl D to duplicate, and I move it 2.5 units to the right. And I change the name of this to green area light. I select the green area light and change the color to green. You can see that I have created two area lights. One is going to emit the red light in this direction. Another one is a green area light which emits the green light in this direction, in the Z direction. After putting the area lights, we are not seeing any changes in the scene. You can see that. The reason is we need to tell to the system that which game objects should be affected by these bake lights. That is, we should tell which game objects are static game objects. So that's what I'm telling here. Steps to generate light maps. Select game objects which must be affected by the area light. So what do you need? Check the static checkbox. So this cube or the ground must be affected by the area lights, right? So I just select here static. Once I select static, the system knows that this game object must be affected by the bake lights. Now the effect of area lights you see on the ground. It takes little bit time. You can see here at the status bar it is telling 6 of 16 bake visibility. So it takes little bit time. You have to give enough time to the system so that the information of the area lights are baked on this game object. So after a few seconds or few minutes, you are going to find the effect of area lights on the ground game object. You can see that half of the part is getting illuminated with the red light and half of the part is getting illuminated with the green light. You can clearly see that, right? You can not only bake the area light, you can also bake the other lights also. For example, point light, spotlight. So what do I do is, I'm going to create another game object here. I say game object 3D object cube. I scale it in x axis by 2, y by 2 and z by 2. And I move it up by 2 units. I minimize the unity. I minimize the word. Here I have a create texture. I'm going to drag it to the assets folder. And I drag the create texture on the cube. I rename this cube to create, C-R-A-T-E, create. And you can see that the create is a dynamic object because I have not selected here static option. So it is not going to be illuminated by the area lights. Just above the create texture, create game object, I am going to create one spotlight. I say game object light, say spotlight. You can see that the spotlight is created. I just place it above the crate and I change the color of this to blue. I increase the intensity and you can see that the crate is getting affected by the spotlight. And I also add the soft shadows to it so that it can cast soft shadows. And one of the thing you can see that the spotlight is of baking type set to real time. Its mode is set to real time. I can change it to baked. That means I can bake the spotlight effect also, guys. So once I set up baked, now the spotlight is of type baked, like area lights. So system takes little bit time and you will see the output after a few seconds once I set this crate to static. So I have set the crate to static and after a few seconds you are going to see the change in the scene. Because it is taking time to bake the information on the textures. So you have to give some time to the system. You don't see the sudden changes. You should see in the status bar. It is showing 7 of 16, 10 of 16. You can see that. 12 of 16. Once 16 of 16 passes are over, you start seeing the effect there. It's 15 of 16. You can see now the effect of baked lights on the game objects. To bake lights or generate light maps, scene must be saved. So what do? I'm going to save the scene. File, save scene as. I create here one folder, right click, new folder with the name scenes. I open the scenes folder. I name this scene as scene 1. Say save. You can see that the scenes folder is created. Inside that we have the scene 1. Next, what do? We go to window menu, say lighting, go to scene tab, uncheck the auto checkbox and click on the build button. I go to Unity, we go to window menu, go to lighting, here we uncheck the auto checkbox and then we click on build option. Once you click on the build option, what Unity does is, it is going to build the light maps information in your assets folder. You can see that it is building the light maps for your current scene. And you can see that it has created one folder called as scene 1. So it has created light maps inside the scene 1 for the scene 1, guys. And now if you go to the spotlight and disable it, still you feel that there is a spotlight. If you select area light, both the area lights and disable them, still you feel that the game objects are getting lit by the area lights, right? So that is called as baking, guys. Note, baking lights is usually the last step in a game production. It is done to increase the performance by reducing the number of unnecessary lighting calculations on each frame at runtime. Of course, you can increase the performance of your game by reducing the unnecessary lighting calculations on each frame at runtime, right? So that is the use of baking lights, guys. Unity does not modify the original textures. It just generates light maps which are overlaid on top of the original textures. So this point you should remember that it is not going to modify your original textures. On the original textures, it is going to put the light map information, guys. So I hope you guys have clearly understood how do we create area lights and how do we bake lights and how the baking lights help us to reduce the number of lighting calculations at runtime. It is very, very useful information, guys. I suggest you people to try this yourself and experiment. In the upcoming video tutorials, we discuss more. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to like, comment, and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys, thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you.